Hi, I'm Amy from the Alti store. Solar panels are quite an amazing technology with the ability to turn sunlight into electricity. How on earth and in space does it do that? The most common type of solar panel used these days on homes and businesses are silicon-based. These solar panels are made from melted silicon rocks. A little bit of a positive chemical element, such as boron, is added to the silicon to make sure the resulting silicon block or ingot has a positive potential. Once the silicon has cooled for days and hardened, the ingot is then sliced into thin wafers, and the wafer is coated on one side with a negatively charged element, such as phosphorus. The combination of the positive boron-infused silicon on one side and negative phosphorus on the other side creates a positive, negative, or PN junction. This is where the magic happens, the photovoltaic effect. Wires are then painted onto the wafer, providing a method to harness the flow of electricity. At this point, the wafer is a solar cell. When the sun hits the negative side of the solar cell, some of the negatively charged electrons are knocked loose from their atoms. They travel across the PN junction to the positive side, where there are holes available for them to settle into. This creates a direct current, or DC flow. This current is measured in amps. Simultaneously, a voltage potential is created between the two sides of the solar cells. Each solar cell is capable of generating about a half a volt. Well, a half a volt doesn't do all that much for you electrically, so several of them are wired together in series, plus to minus, to create a usable voltage. A typical 12-volt solar panel, like we have here, has 36 of those cells in series, generating about 18 volts VMP. A 20-volt solar panel like this, that's commonly used in grid-tie home solar systems, will usually have about 60 cells wired together for 30 volts VMP. Here I've got two 24-volt panels, the Alti 24-volt 100-watt and 200-watt. They both have the same number of cells, 72, but this one's only 100 watts and this one's 200 watts. You can see that each cell in the 200-watt solar panel is twice as big as the cells in the 100-watt solar panel. So that's putting out twice the current, or amps. Since volts times amps equals watts, twice the amps means twice the watts. Multiple solar panels can then be wired together in series to further increase their voltage, which is then called a series string of panels. Multiple strings of panels can then be wired together in parallel to increase the current. Multiple solar panels all wired together make up a solar array. If you found this video helpful, please like and share it. Please watch more of our videos here and subscribe to our channel, Alti Store, to be notified as soon as we release a new one. Also visit our website at altistore.com, where we've been making renewable doable since 1999.